Lining a cooking or baking pan with culinary parchment paper instantly makes cleanup a whole lot easier because nothing sticks to the pan. With parchment paper, there's no need to grease the pan with messy butter or oil. This culinary parchment paper comes in a standard sheet roll or an assortment of specialty shapes. It's heat resistant to a temperature of 450 degrees. Making paper begins with pulp, which is pulverized wood. This parchment paper manufacturer uses eucalyptus because it's a sustainable resource. They mix the pulp with water in a huge industrial mixer. This special recipe of eucalyptus fibers produces tan-colored paper. Once the consistency is just right, they pump the soggy pulp out of the blender and into a machine that spreads it evenly across a metal mesh belt. The water drains through the openings in the mesh. By the time the pulp rolls into the first drum of the next machine, it is formed into a sheet of paper. Sprayers rehydrate what's trimmed off the edges so it can be recycled. The paper travels through a long line of heated rollers. They squeeze out the remaining water and dry the paper. A high-resolution scanner looks for imperfections as the paper exits the machine. Workers unwind the bolt and conduct a visual inspection against backlighting. Next, the bolt undergoes the first of two critical operations, which transforms this regular paper into culinary parchment paper. First, the sheet passes through two baths in a proprietary water-based solution. This eliminates air pockets and renders the paper heat resistant. After a series of rinses, another long line of heated rollers squeezes out the rinse water and dries the paper. The next station sprays both sides of the sheet with food-grade silicone, then bakes on the coating in a gas-fired dryer. Silicone withstands heat up to 1500 degrees. So even at the highest cooking temperatures, there will be a barrier that prevents food from sticking to the paper. Silicone also repels water. This is the paper before the treatments make it heat resistant, non-stick, and waterproof. And here's how the paper performs after those treatments. Because it's waterproof, you can wet the paper to make it malleable enough to line a pan of any shape. The factory cuts the bolts to consumer widths, then shrink wraps and ships them to factories that supply restaurants and supermarkets. Here, machines unwind the bolts, then wind specific lengths of parchment paper onto cardboard tubes. Winding a 165-foot roll takes just 3 seconds. The factory also applies its logo to the paper at regular intervals. However, that operation is top secret. The automated packaging equipment tapes down the edge to prevent unraveling, then places and seals the roll in a cardboard box. The machine stamps the box with a lot code. So if a problem arises, the factory can trace the roll back to the large bolt from which it originated. This parchment paper, cardboard tube, and box are all made from sustainable resources. The box edge is rigid enough to tear off a sheet, so there's no need for an unrecyclable metal cutting edge. You can throw the used parchment paper in your compost bin. or rinse off the food remnants and put it, along with the box and tube, in your recycling bin.